Hello students, in this video we are going to see the literary devices used in the poem Our Casuarina Tree by Toru Dutt. Our Casuarina Tree is a poem published in 1881 by Toru Dutt, an Indian poet. In this poem, Toru Dutt celebrates the majesty of the casuarina tree that she used to see by her window and remembers her happy childhood days spent under it and revives her memories with her beloved siblings. The poem has 5 stanzas, all the stanzas following the same rhyme scheme of A, B, B, A, C, D, D, C, E, E, E. Now let's see the figure of speech used in the poem. The first line, like a huge python winding round and round. The figure of speech used is zoomorphism. Zoomorphism is describing the vine in animal terms as a python. Zoomorphism is the device of giving animal-like qualities to anything that is not that animal, such as humans, gods, plants and innate objects. Here also simile is used. A simile is a figure of speech that directly compares two things. Simile compares two things using comparison words such as like, as, so or that. Here comparison is made using the word like. The creeper is compared to a huge dangerous python. The line, but gallantly the giant wears the scarf, is personification of the tree. Personification is the portrayal of non-human objects in such a way that we feel they have the ability to act like humans. It is the attribution of human characteristics to innate objects. Here the human quality of wearing is given to the tree. And the poet says gallantly the giant, which means bravely or heroically the giant wears the scarf. Hence its personification. Here metaphor is also used. A metaphor is a figure of speech that is used to make a comparison between two things that aren't alike but do have something in common. Metaphor's comparison is more indirect, usually made by stating something is something else. Here the huge tree is compared to a giant. The line, a grey baboon sits statue-like alone. The figure of speech used is simile. The unmoving baboon is compared to a statue using the word like. The water lilies spring like snow enmasked. The figure of speech used is simile. The whiteness of the water lilies is compared to snow using the word like. What is that dirge-like murmur that I hear? The tree is personified again here, which is singing its lament, which might be the wind rustling through the leaves. Dirge means lament. And also here, simile is used. Murmur is like a lament mourning the loss of the past. The lines, what is that dirge-like murmur that I hear, like the sea breaking on a shingle beach? Again here the figure of speech used is simile. The lament is like the sea waves hitting the rocky beach. And shingle means rock. The next line, it is the tree's lament and airy speech that happily to the unknown land may reach. Again the tree is personified here, whose lament, which is an unnatural speech, may perhaps reach far places. Airy means unnatural. The figure of speech used here is personification. In the next stanza, unknown yet well known to the eye of faith. The figure of speech used here is personification. The eye is the organ of sight or vision. Hence it is personification. The line, the waves gently kissed the classic shore. Kissing the shore is personification. The line, the earth lay tranced in a dreamless swoon, is again personification. Here the speaker envisions nature, that is the tree, waves, the earth as a living and maybe even a conscious entity recalling links to the past. Tranced means in a half-conscious state. Who now in blessed sleep for a repose? The figure of speech used here is euphemism. Blessed sleep refers to death. Here, death has been politely mentioned as blessed sleep. The figure of speech is euphemism. Euphemism refers to replacing phrases that would otherwise be considered harsh, impolite, or unpleasant. The line "with deathless trees like those in Borrowdale," again the speaker personifies the tree, that the tree will be remembered like other favored trees, just as she remembers the people in her life. She mentions Borrowdale, and this is a reference to Wordsworth's ode "Yew Trees," another poem praising trees like those in Borrowdale. So the figure of speech used here is allusion. Allusion is a figure of speech in which an object or circumstance from unrelated context is referred to secretly or indirectly. The poet alludes to the yew trees that William Wordsworth wrote about and therefore immortalized. So even if the aforementioned yew trees were to die, they would live on, as anyone who read his poems would be able to see them. Since comparison is made using like, the figure of speech is simile too. Fear, trembling, hope, and death, the skeleton, and time, the shadow. The figure of speech is allusion, because this line is taken directly from Wordsworth's poem. Hence it is allusion. Also in this line, fear, hope, death, and time are personified. All these words are written using the capital letters. That is, first letter has been capitalized, like that of capitalizing the names of human beings. So hence it is personification. And time, the shadow. Here metaphor is used. Time is compared to shadow. Hence metaphor. Now take a look at few examples of alliteration.